Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today we have a question sent in by Brent, and if you have a question for the podcast, please feel free to drop me a note or leave me a voicemail. And unfortunately, Brent sent in a two-part question, and today's part, I don't have an answer for, at least one that's not going to be acceptable. Brent said that he likes to use the data validation to get a drop-down list, but sometimes he has several cells that are merged together, and the drop-down arrow appears way off to the right. He says, hey, is there any way to make the drop-down arrow appear on the left? Well, in case you've never used data validation, it's pretty simple. We just use data and then validation and say that instead of allowing any value, we want to allow a list. Now, normally, we would point to a range of cells that had the data, but we can actually just type the list right here. So A, B, C, D, E, F. Click OK. And what happens is we get a drop-down where we can choose from the list. And Brent's right, when you've merged the cells, that drop-down does appear way, way to the right. Well, the only solution I have for this, and I have to admit it is not acceptable at all, is to go to Tools, Options, and on the International tab, there's a setting where we can change the right-to-left orientation. Say that we want to use right-to-left and then View Current Sheet right-to-left. Well, this does happen to solve the problem of getting the drop down on the left hand side, but it also does a whole bunch of other things that are going to drive us crazy. For example, the numbers, the row numbers, are now along the right hand side of the spreadsheet, and the spreadsheet reads right to left with column A over here, and then B, and then C, and then D. This is set up for those languages which read right to left, for example, Hebrew. So while this is a horrible way to get the drop down arrow to the left side of the cell, I don't think anyone in their right mind would actually do this, because of all the other problems that are going to happen. So, Brent, thanks for sending in your question. Bad news is, I don't think I can solve it. Although, you never know, if someone watching the podcast will come up with a great solution. Now, Brent has a second part of the question about data validation, and we'll get to that one on tomorrow's podcast. Thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. Wow, this is a horrible way to get the drop-down arrow to the left side of the cell. Thanks for stopping by.